Hear ye, hear ye, hear ye. On behalf of the Village of Mariemont and its own town meeting, I bring you welcome and greetings. Let those present know that today is a celebration of the 75th anniversary commemorative and renewal project, which has been undertaken and dedicated today by the Mariemont Preservation Foundation, with Millard Rogers presiding. God bless the United States of America, our state of Ohio, the Village of Mariemont, our mayor, Don Policastro, and our beloved children.
Thank you, town crier Hank Kleinfeld. That's a wonderful introduction, and welcome, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, to this celebration of the 75th anniversary commemorative and renewal project undertaken by the Mariemont Preservation Foundation for the benefit of our wonderful Village of Mariemont. Today continues the vision inaugurated in 1923 when Mary Muhlenberg Emery slipped a silver spade into the ground at Ferris House to initiate the Village of Mariemont, a planned community of international acclaim. Today, this celebration demonstrates the admiration for Mariemont held by many individuals and organizations. Today, we dedicate a project that began with ideas and is now culminated in concrete accomplishments for our village. The history of the 75th anniversary commemorative renewal project, undertaken by the Mariemont Preservation Foundation and involving many, many volunteers, foundations, government agencies, and donors for the benefit of all who love Mariemont, is fully described in the brochure which you have received. And I hope you all were able to get a copy of our brochure that we published to help commemorate this wonderful event. The first in our program, Christina L. Beatty, has been the heart and soul of this 75th anniversary project, involved in all aspects of the planning and execution. She has given untold hours since the project began in 1998 to the supervision and coordination of volunteers, contractors, and government agencies to ensure the project's success. It is no exaggeration to say that the project would not have concluded without her involvement and leadership. Ladies and gentlemen, Chris Beatty.
I did bring a prop. I just thought it necessary for those of you who have seen me for the past 3 years, I just want you to know that I have worn out four of these Stanford sweatshirts, and this woman stomping around the village in the sweatshirts. And I probably have worn out that many volunteers also. This project is so much a community project. From the donors, from the volunteers, the time, the organization, the village council, all of the support that has come together, Mary Emery and John Nolen, you just know are smiling on our village at this point in time. Unfortunately, or fortunately, I do want to mention a few people, because everyone is special. From those that organized, from those that worked in the fields, from the kids that volunteered on the archaeological dig here or at the boathouse. It's just so much for the artworks that came out of the high school. It's just been so wonderful. All of this would not have been possible without the monetary support and the moral and spiritual support of the Thomas J. Emery Memorial. They have been with us from the very beginning, and they were with us till the very end. Other significant donors are the Greater Cincinnati Foundation, which fell in love with John Nolen's 1921 design for the Madisonville site and wanted to see it built. Senator Finan, up in Ohio, the state of Ohio, he wanted to give money for the boathouse. And the state of Ohio gave $50,000 for the boathouse renovation. NatureWorks grant, which we received, which has gone towards improvements here and also at the boathouse. And lastly, I want to mention the preschool parents who have lent their support to the boathouse project dating back many years and hopefully for many years to come. And there were untold others, which are listed in your brochure, that were just so generous with the various pieces of this project. The volunteers, and you can be thankful, I'm not going to list them all. They're probably not even all listed in the brochure. I would like to thank the coordinating committee, which 3 years ago started thinking about it, the entire project, all of its five facets. The floral committee, which made designs for 19 of the village public parks and implemented many of them under the leadership of Ruth Gehring, Peggy, and Don Keyes. Enhanced lighting for the statuary, the cupolas, and finally, the two town squares, Dottie Wakeful and Dick Savage. The Dogwood Park trails, Tough Roll, Ron Colati, bees, poison ivy, you name it. We've been down there, just great. And Kyle Roberts. The John Nolen Pavilion, where we stand, it's just such a significant accomplishment that John Nolen designed this in 1921. MPF held on to that dream and his drawings, thanks heavens, and what you see here is an exact replica of his design and his drawing, and this under the leadership of Fred Rutherford. The Boathouse Nature Center has a longer history because it was built in 1923 by Mary Emery. And after it stopped being used as a boathouse, the Boy Scouts, Eagle Scouts, took it into their heart. They maintained it, they used it, they built steps, flagpole, they oversaw a new roof. It's the Eagle and the Boy Scouts of this community that have kept the boathouse alive all of these years, and we're really indebted to them for that. After the Boy Scouts, because of their activity, we had our first boathouse committee under the leadership of Leslie and Jack Hodell. And they also managed to keep it alive. They held, many of you remember, you'll walk through it today and you'll say, oh, I was Frankenstein in this room, for the haunted houses, which started raising money for the renovation. The 75th anniversary continued and came up with designs, final designs for the Boathouse Nature Center, so that it would have a viable use for this community. And this has been under the leadership of many, but Libby Rutherford and David Jennings have spearheaded this effort. A newly formed Boathouse Board of Overseers under the Village of Mariemont will continue the maintenance and the usage of the boathouse. So this goes on. Finally, I would have to mention one of the most important aspects of all of this is the education program that was developed. And there was an education committee, and it developed an in-school program and program for tours in our historic community, beginning with the prehistoric Indians for this site, with Mary Emery's village. We have so many riches in this community. We currently have 12 active docents, and they are recognizable by their green scarves. And this is Carol O'Brien, Sue Fitz, Kim Berkey, Susan Martin, Gail McBride, Nina Rogers, Claire Kupferle, Marty Breach, Catherine Lento, Ann Foran, and Doug Dockery. And they carry forward the traditions and the history of this community. I have to thank especially those who are working on today's event. I don't know all of them. Gail McBride, Nina Rogers, Kayla Bryan, Claire Kupferle, and Janet Setchell were instrumental in all of this. I would like to thank, I'm almost finished. I would like to thank Linda Badowski for the brochure that you have, commemorative brochure, which is beautiful. It's just a wonderful job. Thank you, Linda. The professionals. I grew fond of many professionals on this work. And I would just, again, mention a very few. David Ahrens, Architecture One, for the boathouse, has just done an outstanding job, not only on the structure, when you see it, it is just magnificent. It is as it was originally, except for the two ADA bathrooms. And putting up with floods and snakes and whatever. He's been most gracious and forgiving through all of it. Dennis Malone of Malone and Wilcox and his son Scott. This building is beautiful. Dennis looked at the drawings and he replicated the drawings. And I don't have the right names. You've got, I forget the roofing along the top. Is that Coxcomb? And the beadwork here. The attention to every detail, finest quality. It was a dream. It was a dream. Thank you, Dennis. Jim Imbus did the roof on the boathouse, and you all know that this took a few years to do this, and the stone finally had to come from Wales to finish this project. And the Imbus Company and the workers there were. They were there every day, and it was just quite remarkable. Martin Kepke, landscape design for this site and the other site, has done a wonderful job. I just have to mention John Scherbenberg of the Village Maintenance Department, who has been there rain, snow, you name it. He has been so helpful. And responsive for all of our projects. And I think lastly, the most important people are the last ones. Without Millard and his wife Nina Rogers, this project, we would not be here today. Over 3 years, and we are still speaking to each other. And I think Millard and Nina are still a happy couple. It has been ups and downs, and it just could not have happened without Millard and Nina Rogers. Also could not have happened without my husband, Jack Beatty. He is the most important volunteer in this entire project. Thanks so much.
We have a special commendation and award from the governor of the state of Ohio, Bob Taft. And I'd like to read it to you before it's presented. In the name and by the authority of the state of Ohio, Bob Taft, governor of said state, hereby officially recognizes Christina L. Beatty for your tremendous leadership and service to the Mariemont Preservation Foundation. Thank you for your time and efforts you have put toward preserving Ohio's history and heritage. Best wishes in all future endeavors. In testimony whereof, I have hereunto subscribed my name and caused the great seal of the state of Ohio to be affixed at Columbus this 10th day of June, 2001, Bob Taft, Governor.
Foundation to Chris, we would like to give you these for all the hours of her time, calling all the contractors, filing for all the grants. She was an outstanding person in this whole project.
Thank Thank you. Amy DeBrunner is our president of the Mariemont Preservation Foundation. Thank you, Amy. We're pleased to have with us now the recorder for Hamilton County, Rebecca Grappi. And I should also add, for those of you who don't know, Rebecca is a resident of our Village of Mariemont. Ladies and gentlemen, Rebecca Grappi.
A number of years ago, well, for those of you who don't know me, I'm Rebecca Prem Grappi, and I'm the Hamilton County Recorder. And the Recorder's Office is charged with the duties and responsibilities of preserving all the land records in Hamilton County. But we also have other things going on in our office. We are in charge of all of the military records, all of the, we have some cemetery records, some churches have begun working with us and providing us with their books on marriages and whatnot. So for any of you doing genealogy research or preservation research, we have an entire department dedicated to just that sort of thing. And what's happened over the last couple of years is that we've noticed a tremendous increase in the amount of historical research being conducted in Hamilton County. And it was mirrored by the amount of interest in historical issues being shown throughout the county. So to preserve and recognize those efforts, and I mean these are exploding interests that are taking place in our county, the Recorder's Office created the Griffin Yateman Award. Griffin Yateman was the first elected recorder in Hamilton County back in 1828 and is the namesake of Yateman's Cove, which you all may or may not be familiar with. And it was named in honor of him. And we've been fortunate over the past few years in that we've received nominations for projects that are so overwhelming and have taken such a great deal of effort that we've been privileged and honored to even come to those sites, and this year was no different. We had the opportunity to recognize an undertaking that takes more than just research into the past, but also takes efforts from an entire community and a group of people to put things just the way they were intended to be. And 2 years ago, we recognized a young leader who was compiling a book listing all of the research and things going on in Hamilton County. And the winner this year, the Mariemont Preservation Society, put together an effort, and you can see part of it before you. And I mentioned to Mrs. Beatty, just as I approached you all today, I actually went to the site, past the yellow ribbons, don't count. And for those of you who have not been down there yet, if you go see it today, you will be just as overwhelmed as I was by seeing what's taken place down there. This is obviously a group of individuals, an entire community that has pulled together, not just to make something happen, but to make it happen, I think, I know you said in 2 years, but that's actually pretty quick for what they have done down there. The stonework alone is just absolutely breathtaking. And so I'd like to present this honor to Mr. Rogers and Mrs. Beatty because they are in charge. And I'd like to tell you a little bit about this, and for those of you who would like to see it, this symbol that we have on top of here is the original logo from the Hamilton County Recorder's Office from 1868. George Hobson was the recorder. This logo was hand-etched into a piece of glass and hand-stamped onto the paper to make their stationery. That is long gone. Luckily, my preservationist in my office, Dave Pittenger, the one with the camera, was able to save a piece of this paper, which we still have in our office, and we have made this our official logo. It is a Buckeye. I checked with Denny McEwen to make sure that's what it was. And I'd like to read this to you. This is the Griffin Yateman Award 2000 for historical achievement presented to the Mariemont Preservation Foundation in recognition of your commitment to historical preservation as evidenced by your 75th anniversary commemorative and restoration project that saw the renovation and the subsequent renaissance of the Charles Larius Boathouse and the John Nolen Pavilion at the Madisonville site. And I'd like to congratulate you. You all really outdid yourself.
Thank you very much, Rebecca Grappi. We're delighted at the for the village to have this award, and also delighted that the Mariemont Preservation Foundation has accepted it. To conclude our program, we just have short while before us before we adjourn to the boathouse, but I would like to present now the mayor of the Village of Mariemont, Dan Policastro.
Thank you. I truly, truly want to thank Mariemont Preservation and all the hard village workers that made all this come true. I mean, truly look at this. This is beautiful. And I think all these people deserve a hand, a great hand. Just a quick story. Wait a minute. If I look like an apple, I umpired 2 ball games a day. So, excuse the way I look. Just a quick story. About 5 years ago, I was down here at a swim meet, and a swim team came in from another community, and a little girl got out of her car, and she was on the swim team. I don't know where they were from, and she said, the swimming pool is over by the dump. I was a little embarrassed, and to be here today and to realize that this group of people raised almost $700,000 to do this, I simply want to say again, thank you, Mariemont Preservation. Thank you all.
But certainly not least, David Jennings. David?
Thank you. I apologize. I was supposed to make my comments at the boathouse, but I thought rather than try and re-adjourn everybody, we just get it over with here and then adjourn. And again, adding my thanks to all the effort that's been made in the past. I've been the co-chair of the boathouse restoration for about 5 years now. And what that position means is you get to watch a lot of great people do a lot of really good work. And it started several years ago with Leslie Hodel and her family, and Barb Kramer and Betty Rhodes and John Kemple, and just I think everybody in the village, in fact, I think I saw all of you there at one time or another. I think everybody in the village participated in the haunted boathouse events. And I have to single out one group because, as you know, the Boy Scouts were involved and they did so much for it. They did all the logistics and traffic and everything for us. And the second year that we had the boathouse, it was determined that the Boy Scouts wouldn't be able to participate. And this was like days before we were, and we had the first time 400 people showed up and we thought, okay, 400 people at the boathouse and nobody to help direct it. And that was a little scary. And I just happened to run into Dan Policastro and I said, Dan, we've got a little issue here. I don't have anybody to work the concessions. I don't have anybody to work the traffic. He said, Dave, don't worry about it. That's what we do. And the Kiwanis and the Mary Elders stepped up with just literally days of preparations, ran everything smooth as silk, and I have to thank both groups, the Kiwanis and the Mary Elders. From that point, even though these things look like we talk about a lot of structures, and they are magnificent structures, when you see the boathouse, if you saw it 3 or 4 years ago, I don't think you're going to believe what you're going to see today. But it's really about the people and their community that really brought all this together. And if I could, you've heard about the effort that Millard and Chris put into this, and every word is true. And I just want to add my own personal thanks to them. We struggled for so long to come up with a purpose and a cause, and we finally landed on the Nature Center. And I think that helped to tie in with the trails and the rest of the project and even link these two facilities together. And there were so many people that put so many hours into it. But the reality of it was, after 2 years of the haunted boathouse, we had raised approximately $7,000 or $8,000, which was just about enough to cover the space heater. And the amount of money that was raised then by Miller and Chris, $700,000. And the number's almost incomprehensible because they worked so diligently, hour after hour. And you know what filling out a grant is, whether it is for Nature Works or the government, anything, it's impossible to do. And they just labored and forever to get this done. And I think, personally, what I've learned from the whole process is that if you want to get something done, and you want to get it done right, these are the people to know. But yeah, absolutely. And I just wanted to say, I've learned so much from this experience. And I think when you break it down, it's the whole community is really about people trying to do their best to raise and nurture their children, to protect and preserve the history of the community, to enhance, elevate, and improve the world around them for the benefit of others, and doing their best to set an example for the community. And I think that's what really brought us here in the first place. And finally, I have to do a little bit of shameless self-promotion here. We have built the boathouse, they have built the boathouse and this beautiful structure, and now we need all of you to come and use the facility. Now, there's soccer games over there, there's baseball games over there, we have all kinds of celebrations and parties, and I hope you'll find needs to use it. I personally, one I'll throw out there, when the Boy Scouts come back from their high adventures, what better place to get together and go through your slides and all of your photos and everything, but at this common facility that's available to everyone. And I just want to show you, I have a couple of props. I have copies, and you'll see these. These are the rules and regulations and the instructions for renting the boathouse. If it's a nonprofit organization, it's free. If it's personal, it's $25. So minimal cost, please. But we really want the community to come out and support it and use it. The one thing we can't do is let it fall back into disrepair. We have to use it. The lesson that I think we should have learned from all of this, that maintenance and repair is so much cheaper than restoration. Let's not make that mistake again, please. So come and use it. Thank you very much. There are, by the way, I know you'll come and see it because the free refreshments are located at the boathouse. Thank you very much.
That concludes our little program today. There's dedication and celebration. We thank you all so very much for coming and sharing this wonderful day with us. Aren't we glad the rain stopped just for us? And you can ride, walk, skip, whatever, down to the boathouse, and we'll see you down there shortly to inspect that wonderful facility and have some refreshments. Thank you again for coming.
Thank you. I suggest get a candid shot, two men get in it, and 1 minute.
All right.
We even do dolls. What are you doing? What's your job today?
Behind your cookies.
It was there and it was
there too. Do you remember what?
Yes.
Like giving the cookies away.
Well, Cisco, yes.
Well, it's very nice of you to volunteer your time to be here today. Very nice of you. What do you do?
Supervise.
You're the supervisor. You're the boss. Well, make sure you do what she says, okay? She's a very good supervisor.